After only 7 pro fights, Leon found himself battling for the heavyweight crown. He had come a long way from the troubled youth on the streets of St. Louis. The questions were endless. Was Leon too inexperienced? Was he big enough? Would the whole thing be a farce? On February 15, 1978, the questions were answered when a 36-year-old Muhammad Ali put his title on the line against an almost playful youngster they called Neon Leon Sphinx. And we were all in for a surprise.
So here we go for round one.
And well, he should have been. He's the most inexperienced guy to be fighting this fight, wouldn't you say, Bob?
Yes, but I tell you, if you see the way he's coming out here with Ali just hanging on the ropes, covering his face, Sphinx is either going to punch himself out or he's going to score a lot of points here, which obviously he is doing at this point so early in the fight.
Well, of course, this is Ali's rope-a-dope strategy, the famous strategy devised in Zaire. And his strategy with this young kid, any young amateur comes in, and Sphinx is a virtual amateur. Ali's whole tactic here is let this kid burn himself out. He's not going to hurt me, and then I'll come on and I'll take the middle rounds or knock him out by the 10th round. If he doesn't do that, we'll see what happens. Of course, you can see as Ali bounces around a little bit, the flab around his middle and his back. He's got a lot of fat on him. He's trained in a sort of bored manner.
How can you take a fighter seriously who's only had 7 fights, Bob?
No, you can't. You know, the one thing that really surprises me about Sphinx is, as we said, he's just sort of a novice professional, but yet he comes flying out here and goes right after this great champion, absolutely showing no respect at all. That was what's surprising me right I see right here.
Well, the thing with Sphinx, he's got a lot of nervous and hysterical energy. I mean, I feel that a guy like this that's so up for a fight can go the whole 15 rounds just on nervous energy. Now, if Ali doesn't put anything on him at the beginning, he'll be punching away for 15 rounds.
Well, one thing to remember, Davy Pearl is the referee as he separates these two fighters. He does not have a vote on the Las Vegas Commission rules. There are 3 judges, and they will do the scoring of this fight.
Ali completely content to let him take this first round and inflict. See those blows to the kidneys there? Those are the things that I objected to so much for him fighting. I just didn't think he needed to get on the ropes and let a guy hammer at his kidneys.
Well, it doesn't seem that Ali, in all his fights, you know, he is not in the habit of letting people pound on him like this. But evidently, this is his strategy, and as we have said many times before, you know, you can tell him what to do, but then he does his own thing.
Absolutely. He's doing exactly what he wants to do.
Okay, we're coming to the end of round one very shortly. And Ali, for the first time, getting off the ropes and talking a little bit to the young opponent, Leon Sphinx. Less than 30 seconds now remaining in the first round. And it's been mostly Sphinx, I would say, Ferdy.
Yeah, well, it's all Sphinx. You can see that he had not thrown a punch, a serious punch, to just then. He threw one right hand and he missed it. Then he talked to him an awful lot. He was just content to let this first round go by. I just don't understand how you do this, because at the end, when they add up the rounds, the last round is just as meaningful as the first round.
Okay, that's just about it for round one, Ali versus Sphinx. Ali bouncing a little bit, and for the first time, Ferdy just being effective with the jab. I haven't seen that, or we haven't seen that for the first 2 rounds. Now he comes out, and the first 4 punches he throws, 5, 6, 7, are all a good jab. The old jab that Ali has been noted for all his career.
This really looks like the first round, doesn't it? It looks like this is what he should have done the first round. The other 2 rounds were like dressing room rounds, where you're just fooling around. Now it's like, here's what it feels like to be in with a champion, boy. Here is what the real champion looks like. And he's doing his movement. He's up on his toes. He's doing that jab off the movement. That's the old Ali. But when he bounces, look at the way the flab bounces with him. Isn't that different from what you've ever seen with Ali?
That is. I think perhaps when he gets out of prior to this fight, in the 5 months since his last fight with Ernie Shavers, he did get a little heavy in the gym, but and it was a little bit worse. But you're correct. When you look at this great champion over the years, the midsection is quite uncharacteristic of him. As Sphinx now beats on him in the neutral corner, and Ali does the old Floyd Patterson, what does he call that, the peekaboo style?
He called it peekaboo. Ali called it the rope-a-dope. He opened his mouth at him like saying, oh, look at this. And Sphinx wouldn't have any of it. He opened his mouth. Sphinx is kind of a wacky character, a lot of fun to be around. And he doesn't absolutely go for any of Ali's sights. He's in with the guy as crazy as he is.
Maybe he doesn't understand it.
That's possible. Certainly nobody understands Leon.
Well, we're in round three. It is for the heavyweight championship of the world. It's scheduled for 15.
Let me point out that what Ali's doing, is bouncing around and jabbing, is his style. But in the meantime, he stopped in the corner, and as you saw, Leon put in 30, 40 punches unanswered. Now, those are big points for the three judges sitting around ringside. Remember that, as you said, Bob, the referee does not score points. Therefore, these three judges are sitting there watching and counting these points. They have the luxury of counting the points.
Less than a minute now remaining in round three. Once again, the champion just leaning back on the ropes and talking, doing more talking, as we said, than he is punching on the challenger. Leon Spinks from St. Louis, the champion, of course, fighting out of his hometown, Louisville, Kentucky.
I again remind you, Bob, and the audience, to count the punches to the kidneys and understand that that's the kind of thing that will cause destruction in enough time, given enough time.
Well, every once in a while, he comes on from the right side like that. Of course, he's hitting gloves, but there he's still getting, connecting to the side of the face of Muhammad.
And the shoulders and the arms, and all of that adds up. As you get to the later rounds, you have a hard time lifting your arms when a guy like Leon's punching your shoulders and your arms.
Less than 10 seconds now remaining in round three as Leon Spinks goes after the champion in a neutral corner, and we're just about the end of round three.
Between rounds, you saw Ali is standing up between every round. He's not sitting down. That's a little gimmick to psych Leon out, who looks across the ring and sees him standing, but it doesn't bother Leon at all. He doesn't even think about that. And you're getting a little mounting excitement in the corner as Drew Bodini Brown is starting to get worried and excited and rattling off that encouragement to Ali. Youngblood, Luis Ari in the corner, all starting to look a little worried. He's just not fighting his fight tonight. And Leon is fighting his fight.
Well, Ali still now a little bit more up on his toes, moving a little bit more.
Leon has his family here. He has Michael Spinks, his terrific light heavyweight brother, who is encouraging him, coming into the corner and talking to him. There's a leaping left hook, which in other days would have been a disaster to do to Ali. He would have nailed you with the right hand doing that.
Well, there's a couple of good hooks. A little uppercut, sort of an uppercut left hook, if that's possible, coming in under the glove and the protection that Ali is trying to afford himself here.
And, of course, that's a strategy to try to teach a boxer. Come between those arms. And you can see from the way Ali's head's going back, he's landing. That's how he got his lip cut, undoubtedly.
Well, Ali has always been pretty a smart fighter. He's got to know, as we're in the sixth round, that that he is getting hit with 10-1 punches as opposed to what he is landing on the challenger.
And it's hard to fathom Ali on almost all occasions, but on this one, probably more than anything in his career, it was hard to imagine what was going through his mind as he was letting Leon Spinks pile up round after round after round. And a tremendous lead, which is hard to overcome with a young kid full of energy and courage to keep fighting as hard as he can till the bell.
A good right hand there by Ali. It looked like it scored.
When you see Ali spread his legs like that and dig in, you know that his mind is thinking straight right hand cover. See, that's his straight right hand position. When he does that, he's thinking right hand over the jab.
Leon Spinks in his seven fights, winning the first five by knockouts. And his two previous fights to this by decisions, both going 110 and 115 rounds. And the man who probably will fight the winner of this fight, Ken Norton, looking on the ringside.
And he certainly knows Muhammad Ali, doesn't he?
Sure does.
The man that broke his jaw and fought him and fought him. And every time they fight, no one knows who wins. It's really something.
Well, probably at this point, he's probably thinking, I better take a closer look at Spinks because he's doing all the punching. And obviously all the scoring.
And I bet he's salivating.
Okay, down to the 10-second mark here in round six. And the champion, Muhammad Ali, defending once again against Leon Spinks.
Ali's got to start picking up the pace. It's already getting too late in the game. Now, he's going to have to start. He's going to put something on Leon and let him quit getting so brave. This is the round that things have got to start turning around in. Eight, it's got to be something going on. And here he goes. But Leon's not buying. Leon's back to... Ooh, look at that hook that Leon just put into his chin. Ali content to grab him around the neck and pull him in.
Obviously, Spink has made many telling blows, but the veteran Ali has been able to handle most of them. I mean, I would say that I have seen fighters, of course, those are more or less slaps and glancing blows, but I've seen fighters knock fighters, other heavyweights down with some of the shots that Leon has landed on Ali.
Well, you got to remember what Sonny Liston couldn't do, Joe Frazier could do, George Foreman could do. Certainly, Leon Spinks is not going to be able to do it because Muhammad Ali has one quality above all else. And that is the quality of being able to take a punch. Toughness, grittiness. Inside of that beautiful face and that beautiful body, there reposes a gargoyle who is really tough.
And obviously, that is correct because just prior to this fight, Ali fought a great knockout puncher with the most outstanding heavyweight record of knockouts at this present time, Ernie Shavers. And Ali was lucky to get away with a decision.
He certainly was, but it was a prime Ali in the last round. He just seemed to pull it out, and Shavers did not know what to do with the champion. That's what makes the difference in the champion, Bob. When you get a guy like Ali, he seems to know how to win a fight in the last round. He pulls that last round cliffhanger as he did in all of the Norton fights, except, of course, for the broken jaw.
Well, he did that with Norton in Yankee Stadium in 1976, and that just about pulled out that victory for him. But I would say that he has picked up the pace here. Perhaps his corner, Angelo Dundee and Boudini Brown, his psych man, have told him, you had better get a move on because the three judges here have been watching the same fight we have, and I think you're trailing a little bit.
Well, I think everybody at home will agree that Ali has just been lazy and has ineffective with Leon, and Leon has fought, carried the whole fight. He's progressed to the point where he is a relentless pursuer, and Ali content to just let him lead in the dance.
I'm trying to recall if, of course, Ali, prior to this fight, was, for the first time in his career, not talking very much, in fact, talking hardly at all. And so I don't recall whether or not, in his silence, he did make a prediction to anyone like he has in so many past years.
No, not in this one. In this one, it was lucky that he showed up for the fight. He was very bored and concerned.
Well, the second's counting down now. Just under 10, 8, 7 in round 8.
I must tell you that we are now in Ali territory. From round 11 through 15 is Muhammad Ali's territory. If he hasn't gotten them by then, he is starting to really wing and pick it up because he has won more fights in this distance between 11 and 15 than I think any other fighter fighting in the heavyweight division. He's a master at controlling the pace and timing of a fight. Leon, for his part, has never been here. He's on virgin territory.
Well, Leon Spinks also, with only 7 fights, went into this, as we said, a decisive underdog at about 8-1. But I'm sure his corner has told him at this time that there's a potential of him, very, very potentially, he can win this fight. And I'm sure he feels that. And he is fighting with that confidence that he's had since the opening bell when he charged across the ring in round 1 and went after Ali, and that has been the tone of this fight up to this point. He has been the aggressor. He has been scoring heavily throughout the first 10 rounds as we go through the first minute here of round 11.
He simply won't admit that he's in with a living legend. He simply won't admit to himself that he's in with a man much, much superior to him in talent and, of course, experience. He is just, as far as he's concerned, another fighter fighting in there. And Leon has that wonderful ability to block everything out and just take care of the man in front of him, which, of course, is what you've got to do if you're going to survive in boxing. You can't be reading press clippings and history books. The guy in front of you is just another fighter. As far as Ali is concerned, these are the rounds that he pulls it out in. Of course, the 11th, he's not doing much.
Well, with the question remaining here with 5 rounds to go as we reach the halfway point of round 11, is the champion got enough time to make up perhaps what he has lost earlier as we have witnessed here through 10 rounds?
And also, has he got enough energy to go? And also, can he take that 15th round if Leon comes up as fresh as he looks now? We got a long way to go, and Ali is not doing anything dramatic right here in the 11th round.
Well, Ali has not been knocking out opponents with much regularity in the last several fights he's had. In fact, I think you've got to go back to 1976 when he KO'd Richard Dunn in Munich, Germany, and he's had several fights since then. So if he's thinking knockout, or he was thinking knockout, Leon, it looks at this point, is the greatest shooting by both of these fighters. And that is it for round 11. Scheduled for 15, there have been no knockdowns. Judging will be done not by the referee, but by 3 judges. stationed at ringside.
And the 12th round started with a repeat of every round. Leon just comes out like if it was the first round. He's just fresh as a daisy. He doesn't seem to be tired at all. He doesn't seem to be bored with punching Ali, certainly. I mean, if this is indeed Ali territory, it is not affecting Leon Spink, who at this point looks like he could tap dance through a minefield.
But there's no question that the 8-1 underdog, Leon Spink, perhaps got some of those, the capacity audience in Las Vegas, perhaps thinking upset at this point.
Well, it's certainly a lot of tribute that's got to be given to Leon Spink. So Leon is fighting with all his heart and every fiber of his body. He knows he's got the heavyweight championship within his grasp. He's not about to be denied, and he's not getting careless. He's not going to sleep. He's not letting Ali get started. He's right on his case. And I must tell you, it is a great, great exhibition of courage and drive by a young and relatively fresh kid against a living legend.
Well, there's Ali now with a good combination, a couple of uppercuts, a couple of left and right to the side of the head of the challenger, Leon Spinks. But the challenger, Spinks, comes right back.
But not hard in punishing. Ali is not hard in punishing. He's pity-patting around. Those are all little pity-pat punches. They're not hard and punishing punches. And that's what he's got to do to keep Leon off. And when he gets his legs spread, as we've said repeatedly, you know something hard is coming. That's the only time you see Ali punch hard in this fight so far. And he's got to do more than that pity-pat, because this little kid is not going to listen to anything but hard punches.
And there have been, although there have been several effective blows thrown by, mostly by Leon Spinks, missing there with a right past the right left ear of Ali. Neither fighter, as we said, has been knocked down, and now neither fighter has really been stunned at any time.
The story of this fight so far has been the persistence and drive and unrelenting push and shove of Leon Spinks, who just seems to pace the heavyweight championship. He bobs and weaves and makes Ali miss. Ali tries to get up on his toes, looks like a sort of pathetic imitation of himself. He's just not Ali tonight. You can feel it, you can sense it.
Oh, here's a great exchange. Ali trying to come back, but Spinks still bearing in, not letting the champion get set as he'd like to be, and of course handling every punch and every jab that for the most part has been ineffective through these first 12 rounds. And we move down now inside 10 seconds.
Punching away there, and
oh, what a left hand by Ali right at the bell. The packed house here in Las Vegas sensing a possible upset as we go to the final two rounds.
And you could hear that corner. Everyone was talking there. Even Rockman Ali, his brother. You could hear his voice. You couldn't see him on your screen. Was telling him, come on, champ. It's only six more minutes. Come on, go out like a champion. Of course, you don't have to tell that to Muhammad Ali, because believe me, that man is every inch a champion.
Well, less than 6 minutes now remaining. Will Ali, the big question at this point, after the first seven or eight listless rounds by the champion, will Leon Spinks become one of the most inexperienced heavyweights ever to win this title, this coveted title?
I must tell you, at this point, I found this so heartbreaking. I had a hard time watching this, because here was a man who would easily dominate the heavyweights for 15 years, being handled easily by a novice almost. And you can say that he handled him easy this round. And it's heartbreaking to his corner. It's heartbreaking to the crowd, who just can't believe what they're seeing. Look at Ali going back into the ropes, falling from a nothing punch. It is absolutely heartbreaking. Again, that's the only term that comes to mind, when you see this beautiful man taking this kind of a humiliation at the hands of a novice.
Well, there's no doubt about it that Leon Spinks, the young challenger out of St. Louis, spells victory here. A major upset. The 8-1 underdog pouring it on, continuing to put the pressure. And I'm sure he is making the judges feel, the three judges, not counting the referee, Davey Pearl, who does not have a vote, that this is his fight, this is his championship, and then before this night is over, he is going to be the new heavyweight champion of the world.
But still, you got to go through 15 with Ali. You don't get there that easy. You got to fight it out with Ali in the 15th round. But now you're watching Ali tired. He's bounced around. Now he can't even take Spinks punches when he wants to go into the rope-a-dope. You see him fall back into those ropes in sort of a dead weight thing. You never saw Ali do that.
Okay, there is no tomorrow for the champion with his back to you on the ropes, as the aggressive young challenger sensing victory, a tremendous upset possibly in the making here in Las Vegas. Three more minutes, less than 3 minutes now, and will Ali successfully defend his title for the 20th time?
Ali's got to go toe-to-toe. He's trying to go toe-to-toe, but miracle of miracles, Spinks is outspeeding him, which is something you never see. Now, here they are again, right in the middle of the ring. Ali should be punching with both hands, but instead, it's Spinks that comes back, and he's throwing everything he's got in both punches. Ali is covering up. Ali should be fighting, but he's not. It goes Spinks again. He's doing what he's done for 14 rounds, punch with both hands as hard as he can. Ali resting. Why is he resting? It's the 15th round. He's got to be coming on. Is he saving himself for the last minute? What a mistake that would be. Here comes Spinks again. He's keeping him in his corner. He will not let him out. Now they're punching. Oh, he just got hammered. Spinks just got hammered with the right hand. And now Spinks still in front of him, still won't move back. Now he just got hammered again. Another left and a right. Another right by Ali. But Spinks punching now. Spinks is in the corner, and Ali's got him where he wants him. Ali should be going with both hands. There it is. Left and a right. A left and a right. A left and a right. And Spinks comes back with a counter. Another counter. Another. Another. And there's Spinks backing up the champion. Hitting him with both hands. And there's Ali having his back to the ropes, trying to pot shot. One good shot, and that was it. That right hand. Back again with both hands in desperation. It's almost a futile effort. But Leon, can he take that kind of punishment? Leon is taking it, and he's coming back. It looks as if Ali has almost shot everything he can. He stopped in mid-punch there. Oh, what a right hand by Spinks. And Ali is trading back and forth. Now Ali is trying to rest. Leon will get started. There is Ali. He has delivered two or three, four, five punches. Then he grabs Spinks, and Spinks falls back in the ropes. What action, Bob?
Tremendous action by the champion here. Where has he been for the previous 14 rounds? We are at the 42nd. Another desperation left missed by the challenger. Ali onward, but still pursuing, hoping, praying that perhaps one of these punches will connect, and the gallant challenger, Leon Spinks, will fall. 24, 23 seconds.
Spinks dead tired. Dead tired. It looked like he was out, but he came right back. And now it's Ali that's showing the signs of awareness. He didn't. That's really a shuffle forward. Now it's 13 seconds. Now Leon, having him against the rope, is throwing everything he can. It's 8 seconds away, or he's lost it. He's just hammered Ali. Ali looks like he's in trouble. He's leaning against the rope. It's 2 seconds. It's one, and it's a bell. A tremendous right hand. Look at Ali stagger back.
Let's go down to the pandemonium that is taking place in the ring and the official announcement.
Archery scores 143, 142, Ali. Judge Lou Tabbitt scores 145, 140, Spinks. Judge Harold Buck scores 144, 141, the new.
There it is.
Leon Spinks has pulled it off. He has pulled off the upset of upset. This young kid is now the heavyweight champion of the world, beating maybe the greatest fighter of all time, Muhammad Ali.
Seventy 70,000 people filled the Superdome, and they saw a rejuvenated Muhammad Ali.
Round two.
Ali runs out across the ring at him. He really wants to finish this up in the first six rounds. That's a terrible mistake if he doesn't do it, because Spinks will be there.
Pretty good right hand under the chin of Ali by Spinks. No cuts, nobody hurt. We're only in round two, just on the way. Scheduled for 15. Little of the hook, really not doing much jabbing this former champion, one of the best weapons he ever had, one of the best weapons we've ever seen in a fight game by any heavyweight ever. A fine enough jab, but hardly being thrown by the champion.
He's back on his toes again.
Spinks hit him on the break. Taking a shot on the break. Both fighters missing on the right, on the ropes, into neutral corner. 2 minutes to go, oh, and round two.
Ali
he's still trying to bounce around a little bit, but Spinks is determined. He just keeps coming.
Well, I don't know if Ali can keep this up for 15 rounds, but he has sure moved. He probably moved already more in 2 rounds than he did in 15 the last time they fought. Lafleur, the former champion, is a man of his word because he is moving and circling and trying to stay out of the range of the sharp punching Leon Spinks, the champion.
Just a rough, that's terrible. It's just a rough house that,
Leon throws and smiles, throws up his gloves and says, well, what do you want to do?
Nothing bothers Leon Spinks. He's trying to jab him. Ali's trying to jab him across with the right hand. But he's not landing solidly, and Leon, in the meantime, is still right in his face where he's supposed to be.
Well, he certainly is missing more than he's hitting.
Now, Leon is doing what Benton told him. Get down low and roll. Benton told him, get down low and roll. And after Ali throws, you throw in front of his grab. And he's doing just what Georgie Benton told him.
And that is what's causing the former champion Ali to move. And he's missing
down there, he's down there, and he can't get him.
30 seconds remaining in round two. That was. Now they're tied up again in the center of the ring, and the referee slaps him apart. Ali slaps Spinks in the head with a left jab. They're in Ali's corner now.
Spinks wants to fight, and Ali's grabbing. That's the way he's got to do it if he's going to survive.
To pick it up a little bit. Started out strong. Ali had a good round three. And we're just underway in round four.
All of that bouncing is good if it accomplishes something, but just bouncing for the sake of bouncing is not impressing anybody. He's getting tired. And Spinks, in the meantime, is very economical in his motion.
Two minutes to go in round four. Nobody has been down. It's scheduled for 15. Nobody's cut.
Ali put in two stiff jabs, tried to cross the right hand, and just missed. It would have been a good punch. Spinks led with a right hand and went right into him.
Ali, a very serious fighter. No talking, no rope or dope, no smiling, just down to business, the former champion. .130 remaining in round four.
Ali took a tough right hand to the nose that time.
Good left to the face by Spinks. Coming after him with right hand. Into the belly now goes the champion.
Spinks is a massive determination coming right after him. He's fighting back.
We're in the final minute of round four.
Just missed his right hand again. He's missing that right. If it lands, it'd be interesting to see what happens to Leon.
Now we're down to 30 seconds.
There's 30 seconds, and Leon is still coming up. Two straight jabs by Leon, and now we're starting to go back to February.
Down to the final 10 seconds in round four. Ali comes in with a right hand that grazes the top of the head of the champion Spinks. Two left jab, trying to follow the right as the champion, but he misses.
Ali has been conning and kidding Spinks into not fighting. And he's got to do what he just started out to do right now. He's got to go chase him again. Whether Spinks is letting Ali get tired or not, we'll soon see. That might have been a bad mistake, but he certainly has broke up a lead.
Good uppercut. Little left hand on the left side of the face of Spinks. Ali jobbing in a great right hand by the former champion at the 2 minute mark of round 8. And Spinks doesn't like it. He comes back swinging with both arms and landing.
Spinks is too lackadaisical when he... Ali counts him into quitting fighting. He couldn't do that in Las Vegas. When he relaxed, Ali is getting the best of him now. Ali's ahead.
Well, he's still moving, the former champion. And they love it here.
And he's winning another round. Oh, that was a
good,
beautiful body shot. That may be the first body shot he's thrown since 1960.
And I think he knows that he may have stung the champion a little bit because he's going right after him. Less than a minute here, Valley.
And he definitely stung Spinks to the stomach and doubled him over.
It was a picture punch, Freddie. Right smack in the solar plexus. And they hurt. And they slow you down.
And your legs go where that goes. Ali is unmarked. Not even puffing. Not even breathing hard.
Up on 20 seconds in round 8. And Ali on his way, perhaps, Ferdy, to winning another round.
He certainly is well on his way to winning this round.
Starting off the round with a good left, and Spinks coming right back and getting on top of him. But Ali tying him up as he has done. Spinks now shoving his glove, and Ali's face trying to say, "Get away. Let me hit you. I'm going to hit you."
Ali landed a right hand.
And a good right hand. The former champion. I don't know. Maybe that body punch took something out of this champion.
I think all those right hands Ali's been landing took something out of him. I'll tell you, Ali's been popping a jab and crossing the right on this guy, and he's like going to sleep. Look at all these jabs. And Spinks without a return. He's giving him a boxing lesson.
Clinging. No question about it.
Ali is showing him what it's like to be in with a real Ali.
Not only, and the boxing lesson is totally confusing the champion. He's got him missing. He's tying him up. He's doing all the great things. But it does show him what the art of defense is like.
Well,
besides that,
he's showing him why he was the greatest fighter in the world and why he, even at this age, is great.
.130 remaining in round 9. And who'd have believed that up to this point, the former champion, controlling the fight, dancing, moving, no rope-a-dope, you know it'll work. The man won, Ali said, it's going to work. That's exactly what the former champion is doing. He's working. To go on round 9, and Ferdy Pacheco, he established the fact you had been in his corner for more than 15 years. When is the last time you can remember seeing Ali?
You'd have to go back to Manila, and when he was really in the condition to fight Joe Frazier, to see him this sharp and this good. He has really turned back the clock today. He's given him a boxing lesson, and Spinks doesn't know what to do about it.
Only boxed over 200 rounds getting ready for this fight. Said he worked hard. His weight showed it. He was down to 221 from 224. But he just put a pretty good right there.
He's got to start to take something. It's the ninth round. He hasn't been hit real good yet. He's building up such a lead that Spinks...
Two great shots and another good left hook. Leon came back, but he missed Wiley. Another big round. 30 minutes. Going on 31. The champion is... The former champion still moving. Still frustrating the champion, Leon Spinks. Bouncing, waving. Left and a right, and tying up the champion. Scoring point. Clean hit.
Catching Leon coming in. Leon thinks he's back in February when he can come in and nobody's going to punch him. He doesn't realize he's paying a price to come in. He's fighting the real Muhammad Ali now. Jab and stab. Shock him and lock him. That's what he's fighting. He grabs him and he holds him. No way. No way to beat that. And look at Ali, still bouncing. Look at Ali bounce.
You know, as you look at him now, his jab has become more effective than it was in the opening three or four rounds.
Because Prince has become very, very frustrated and slow, and he's willing to take those jabs to try to get him close, which is a bad mistake. There's a bunch of Ali... A bunch of Ali jabs add up to a knockout.
Yeah, he used to win a lot of fights with that left hand.
Oh, yeah.
And that jab.
Many years of winning fights with jabs.
But they got to hand it to the champion. He's just coming in. He got another right hand in his face.
He's not going to be able to take much more of this if Ali can continue this. And Boudini is hollering. Boxing.
Oh, another one.
Another.
Three right hands.
He is now right on target. A left jab and a right hand.
And Ali's corner is ecstatic.
Ali's corner is hysterical because they...
The biggest round of the fight here in round 11 for the former champion.
Boudini's yelling.
And the crowd of more than 70,000 here anticipating that Ali once again may be on his way to becoming the champion that he always was. Tremendous fight being put up by the former champion Muhammad Ali. Angelo Dundee, Ali's trainer, telling him, Stay all over. There he is. He comes out, hits it with two left and punished for the right. Muhammad Ali.
Ali's hitting him. As Spinks winds up the punch, he's getting hit. Well, Ali certainly saved everything for the fight. As bad as he looked in training, he looks good in this fight.
Notice now he's starting not to move as much. Brody, you see this?
He doesn't need to. He doesn't need to. All he needs to do is survive the 15, and he's the next champion of the world.
For the third time, unprecedented, if he does it. Then he says he wants to retire. Retires the first black ever to retire as heavyweight champion of the world.
And that's my wildest dream. If he ever did that, I'd be one of the happiest men in the world.
But I will tell you...
Because he could go out on a high night like tonight.
I will tell you this, as we go with 2 minutes remaining in round 12, the way he's working tonight, it's going to be awfully hard to convince Muhammad Ali should he win this fight, and he will retire.
Absolutely.
Oh, it's going to be coming after him.
Because this is the highlight of any career. To do this the third time at 36, what everybody thinks you're through, is an absolutely impossible thing. He has once again done the impossible.
Halfway through round 12, scheduled for 15. And the former champion, Muhammad Ali, riding with this crowd of better than 70,000.
And
and on his way to maybe once again becoming the heavyweight champion of the world, doing what no man has ever done. But it's still round 12. It's still lots of time for the champion to retain his title. 1 minute remaining in round 12. Jabbed by Ali. Moving, sticky. Jab and coming in with an uppercut that doesn't quite connect. Ali trying an uppercut, winding up with sort of a bolo punch. Not too effective because he got tagged with it. Nice thing. Good downstairs.
It's all Ali. It's all Ali. Ali is dictating the pace of the fight. Ali is dictating where he fights and when he fights.
Oh, a great left hooky! Big baby hurt! His knees buckle momentarily.
30 seconds of that to go. With a thought like that, he hooked him three times and then grabbed him. He should have continued to attack because Fink looked dazed, bewildered, and ready.
10 seconds to go! Another great fight! Seconds to go. There's the bell. A big round for the former champion. They have to be separated. 70,000 on their feet as we go to the 13th round.
And this place is going to go wild when Muhammad Ali wins this title, because it is an unheard of, unprecedented thing to do by a man who's been acclaimed the greatest fighter of all time.
And as he has done for the last 7-8 rounds, Ali coming right out, establishing authority, landing a straight jab to the chin of Fink. The Fink ties him up and pushes him into his own corner.
He's laying his traps and he's laying his plots for Fink, and Fink is biting on everyone. And he's up on his feet, and I can't believe it. It's round 13 and he's on his feet. Oh, and another great right hand.
Good right hand.
A good left hook. Actually bouncing in the 13th round. Ali,
and a shuffle.
And a shuffle, and that cocky, old, arrogant Ali. Hey, this is a different guy, sonny. This is the world heavyweight champion, the greatest fighter of all time. And Fink doesn't know what to do.
Assuming he's, and it looks like he's been much in command. But he just gags now, sternly, being a defensive fighter. Would you do that? Would you tell him just to hold on? Is he going to get that from his corner?
He doesn't force it anymore. Fink has no way to beat Ali, and Ali is not letting him have a way to win. He is not thinking of a way to lose. Ali's on top of him. 1 minute and a half. And we're getting closer. It's round 13, and we're in Ali territory. This is where Ali has always shone, 13, 14, and 15. But in this fight, he's been shining since round 5.
If they go to 15, 30, I guarantee you it'll be some outstanding round. I'll find out that.
And it's going to be the closest thing there's ever been to a shutout in a heavyweight championship fight.
All right. You heard it from a man who spent 15 years in Ali's corner. Dr. Ferdy Pacheco, the fighting doctor, with his commentary room. And I believe, like everybody else here at ringside at the Superdome in New Orleans, it's Ali's fight. It's his only to lose now, Ferdy.
It's his only to lose, and he doesn't look like he knows how to lose. 15 years with this man, I can tell you, he can think of more ways to win than anybody I know. And he knows no way to lose. Fink looks over, blinks, and he is bewildered. He is hurt. He is stunned, and he doesn't know what to do about it. And Fink, Ali is not lighting up. Ali is on his case.
10 seconds remaining in 13.
Ali is not going to rest around. He's going to go like this for all 15.
Okay. Round 14.
And what I like about it, Bob, is that he is not easing up. He knows he's got his one. He's not going to ease up. He's going to win every round. He's going to show everybody he is there all the way.
The most shocking.
And he is dancing. Passing. Round 14.
That's the most shocking thing.
And he is dancing.
1-2. Going after it again. Back in the box. The former champion. And Fink walks into another left. Ali's corner is, they're up on their feet. They're screaming. They know that victory is just around the corner, maybe 5 minutes now away. If their man could hang in there. This needs a knockout. That appears to be Bertie, his only salvation at this point. This man just doesn't get knocked out.
The man has not been done it. Sonny Liston, by George Foreman, nor by Joe Frazier, and he's certainly not about to get knocked out by Mr. Spinks.
He is showing no sign of being fatigued. Look at him bounce. It's a thing of beauty.
He does it better. I don't remember a fight where he didn't fool around, where he didn't kid with the audience, where he didn't talk to the referee. I don't remember a fight where he was this dead serious. I hope that this means he wants to show the world that this is what Muhammad Ali is all about, and let it go right there. Let him remember this fight as it's a swan song, because it can't be better. It's a shutout.
Less than a minute and a half now, and round 14. The former champion, Muhammad Ali, still in command.
And for the first time, I see Ali talking to Spinks in the clinch. And he's saying, give it up, boy. There's nothing else to do here.
We're in the final minute of round 14.
And this
good right hand, as Spinks comes back and hits him with a right, just shoves the left in Ali's face as he pushes him into the rope. Spinks hasn't landed a real solid blow since the early rounds. Oh, a rousing right hand. It could have taken the former champion out, but just grazed across the face.
He's missing. Too late with it, Bob.
Down 14. The former champ moving ever so close now to becoming only the first man in history to win the title 3 times.
And for the first time in the fight, he's shown a little signs of weariness in the clinch. He is now showing the first signs, and it certainly is pardonable.
Calls them together, they touch gloves, and here it is for the heavyweight championship of the world, round 15.
And who would have thought it, Bob Halloran, that we would get to round 15 and Ali's still bouncing?
Nobody. Good uppercut.
Spinks has got to go wild because there's nothing left. There is no tomorrow. This is the final round of the heavyweight championship, and he has no chance to win a decision.
Good jab by the champion. Stuck four in a row in the face of Ali. Hit him with a right hand on the left side of the face.
Spinks finally woke up to do what he was supposed to be doing at the beginning.
Possibly too late. We'll see. The crowd feels a victory for Ali. They're starting to chant, Ali, Ali. They know it. 2 minutes. Separating the former champion from once again wearing the crown. Leon Spinks may be beaten, but still in there. Letting fly with his right and his left. Trying a haymaker and missing as Ali just gracefully steps out of the way.
Ali has shown all the class and all the talent and all the strength and all the determination of the young Ali with Sonny Liston.
Not
of the Ali with George Frazier.
1:30 remaining in this fight.
And of the Ali of Africa with Foreman. And now here in New Orleans, at the age of 36 years old, he is showing a young man what boxing is all about. He is showing a young Leon Spinks what it's like to be in with the real Muhammad Ali. And what it's like is a shutout. And look at Ali bounce.
He's going to bounce right into the crowd. 1 minute remaining. 1 minute for the World Heavyweight Championship. There have been no knockdowns in this fight. Neither fighter has been really hurt. There are no cuts. And a great right with less than a minute by Ali. But Spinks coming back. Going after the former champion. Probably all in vain.
30 seconds to go. And unless Leon Spinks has got some superhuman effort in him,
Well, kiss his crown goodbye. Well, good right hand by Spence. The old butterfly is singing again. Well, Bobby, there it is, 11 seconds.
11
There'll
seconds.
There'll be no knockout, that's for sure. There never was going to be one. 8-7. That is about it, folks.